Did you ever wonder which is the biggest feature of Java 8 and why this version is still popular even though new versions have been released? This is John from Java Code Geeks, and today I'm going to show you how to write clean and efficient code in Java by using Lambda expressions. Lambda expressions are introduced in Java 8 and they are the biggest feature of this version because it facilitates the functional programming and simplifies the development a lot. These expressions are similar to methods but they don't need a name and they can be declared and used right in the body of a method. Now, complementary to this video tutorial, you can find the related articles and resources in the description below. Of course, you can visit Java Code Geeks to stay up to date with everything Java related. Now, before you continue, if you guys like these guides and videos, take a minute to subscribe, like, and hit that notification bell just so you know when the next video is up. So, with no further ado, let's get started! The Lambda expressions are used to implement functional interfaces by defining an anonymous function that can be passed as argument in a method and also helps to filter, iterate, and extract data from a collection. A Lambda expression is a short block of code with 0, 1, or multiple parameters and returns a value. More specifically, we declare the argument list, or in other words, the parameters in parentheses, then the arrow token, and last but not least, we write the body of an expression. The expressions are limited because they cannot contain arguments, loops, or variables, and immediately must return a value. In case that we want to do more complex operations, we can use the curly braces. Finally, the type of this anonymous function is the same type with the type of the value that returned from the code block. Now, let's see a programming example when Lambda expressions is used to print data from a collection. At first, we declare a class with a name first example and then we write the main method. In order to create a new shopping list, we will use an ArrayList object with string type of values. Then we initialize this shopping list with some items. Usually, if we need to print all the elements of the list, we could use a loop, for example, a for loop. So we can see that all the elements of the list was printed. But now with Lambda expressions and the help of the forEach method, we can have the same output with fewer lines of code. The only thing we need to do is to call the forEach method for the shopping list, put as parameter the length of the list at the parentheses, and last but not least, write the print command at the body of the expression. After the execution of the program prints again all the elements of the list. As we said before, Lambda expressions are used by functional interfaces, but how we can declare a functional interface and which is the main difference from a simple interface? Concerning interfaces, to declare them, we can write the interface keyword and the name. An interface can contain variables and methods, with the methods are by default abstract. So, in other words, we can say that an interface can contain only method signatures that must be implemented by a concrete class. A concrete class that implements an interface must implement all the methods that are declared in it. To implement an interface, we can write the implement keyword and the name of the interface after the class declaration. The same rules are followed to declare a functional interface, but the main difference is that it contains only one abstract method. To understand better the use of the Lambda expressions at functional interfaces, let's see a programming example. So, the first thing we need to do is to create a new interface with a name second example interface, and then to declare a new method signature with a name data. The next step is to create a new class with a name second example, and inside the main method we can create a new string with a name name. In case that we don't want to use Lambda expressions to implement the interface method, we just need to create a new second example interface object and an anonymous inner class. So finally, we just implement the data method using the string and then we call it. As you can see, the Java Code Geeks team is yellow. Now, to avoid this tricky part with anonymous inner class, we can use Lambda expression. So after the declaration of a new second example interface object, we can write the Lambda expression body to implement the method. After the execution of the program, we can see again that the Java Code Geeks team says hello. Last but not least, in case that the method signature data has parameters, the only difference with the above example is that we need to write them inside the parentheses of the Lambda expression, and then we implement the method. In this example, we add two numbers, return the result, and we call the method. As we can see, the addition of 5 and 6 is 11. In conclusion, Lambda Expressions is an inline code that implements a functional interface without creating a concrete or anonymous class, and helps us to have fewer lines of code and write faster and cleaner methods, looking at each method call and know exactly which interface is used, having sequential and parallel execution support by passing behavior as an argument in methods, and last but not least, achieve higher efficiency in case of bulk operations on collection, such as internal iteration rather than external iteration. So, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to smash the like button and subscribe to our channel. We have some really cool stuff coming up. Bye!